Reverend, you are on duty today. Can you think, just think about the man whom you are going to encounter in an hour from now? Less than an hour from now?
I really am going there without any expectations. I'm going there to experience what God has prepared for me, for him, for all of those involved. And I don't preconceive anything, not today. I will let that happen as it occurs, as time gets there. We have a loving, caring, forgiving, merciful God. And in time of joy, and in time of need, and time of trial or tribulation, God is always there for us. I want to make that presence to them.
And technically, when he's led to the gurney, what is your duty then?
After everything is completed, as far as the preparation, then I walk over and I stand as he has allowed me to stand. I always ask permission to be able to stand at his feet and hold his ankle. And I move toward that position and I place my hand on his ankle. And then that's what I do until death occurs.
And if there is no family interested in taking care of the body, the condemned men would end up right behind you?
Yes, they end up here at the state cemetery, and they're buried by the state. No names on the crosses, only numbers.
Why does God allow capital punishment?
I don't know the answer. I believe that there's always a purpose why God allows things to happen. God has created so many things in this world. I play golf sometimes. I love to be on the golf course because one thing I do, I put my phone on a silent mode. I go out there sometimes by myself, with no distractions, and I can see the beautiful grass. I can see the squirrels from time to time running. Sometimes the deer are running. Sometimes I look across the golf course and I see a cow or a horse, and I stop and I acknowledge life. Life. The things that God has created.
Please describe an encounter with a squirrel.
An encounter with a squirrel. I was driving the golf cart, and I was on the cart path, and I saw two squirrels. They were chasing each other, and as I was getting closer, they were running across the cart path, and I put on my brakes, and they stopped in the middle of the cart path and looked at me, and I said, how about this? If I wouldn't have stopped, I could have run over one of these squirrels. Their life would have ended, and that reminds me. Many people that I have been with on their last breath of life, and due to bad choices and mistakes in their life, their life is taken away in the moment. So life is precious, whether it's a squirrel or a human being. So I will sometimes meditate on that experience, make a little noise, and the squirrels will take off and continue their life. But I cannot do that for someone on the gurney. I cannot stop the process for them. But I wish I could.